A near worst-case scenario has just occurred at the erupting Ruang volcano in Indonesia. As a result, a tsunami watch is now in place for the western half of Tagulandang Island, and Ruang's alert level was raised to its highest level, red. At approximately 7:40 p.m. on April 17th, the pressure which had been building up under a newly emplaced lava dome was finally released, creating a sustained massive plume of ash which shot to a height of 21 kilometers or 69,000 feet. As part of the eruption column collapsed back to the ground, pyroclastic flows were generated which not only destroyed the vast majority of volcano monitoring equipment on Ruang Island, but also raced across all sectors of the island, especially towards the east, which even reached the ocean. Because such a large volume of ash was ejected, the force of many millions of tiny particles rubbing together created static electricity, leading to a rapid series of flashes involving volcanic lightning at a rate of dozens per second. A true VEI-4 Plinian eruption was underway, occurring alongside the generation of a 2 kilometer or 6,600-foot high sustained lava fountain which rose above Ruang's summit. Some erupted fragments of tephra are falling back to the ground on the adjacent island of Tagulandang, ranging in size from a millimeter to 3 centimeters in diameter, where they can be heard bouncing off roofs like large hail. The associated eruption column is sustained and has now been ongoing for more than 2 hours, sending very large amounts of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, and this will almost certainly lead to widespread regional flight disruptions or cancellations. Before I continue, I have seen way too many videos and photos of people watching the eruption on the western shore of Tagulandang Island. For the love of everything that is good, get out of there! You are too close not only to a potential tsunami which might be generated, but also to pyroclastic flows which, although none have traveled beyond the island yet, could easily travel across the 1,050 meter gap between the two islands. If either occurred, you would likely have insufficient time to escape. Instead, get to higher ground, preferably at the center of Tagulandang Island or at least 100 meters above sea level. If you do travel outside, wear a helmet at all times, and if you do not have a helmet, use a pan to protect your head from falling debris. I shouldn't have to say this, but I am, especially because I have received numerous reports of volcano tectonic quakes and harmonic tremors so strong that they are frequently shaking the adjacent Tagulandang Island. People will likely die today if common sense is not used. Not only this, but all 22,000 residents who live on this island are being told to be prepared to potentially evacuate. As for why a tsunami watch is in effect, the main reason is that larger pyroclastic flows, now that smaller ones have reached the ocean, could generate enough displacement in the water to create tsunamis that could wipe out coastal communities on Tagulandang Island. Such tsunamis could technically reach much further than Tagulandang Island, which is why further alerts may need to be issued at a later time. Here are the series of events which rapidly escalated in the last 18 hours. After a lava dome was quickly built above Ruang's summit crater, at 7 a.m. degassing from the summit crater completely ceased, indicating that a major plug had formed. As pressure built up over the following hours, the volcanic tremor grew more and more intense. Then, at 4 p.m., some of this pressure was released 4.4 kilometers to the north-northwest of Ruang's summit, causing lava to explosively erupt onto the ocean floor at shallow depths. At 5 p.m, eruptive activity resumed at the summit crater, but this was insufficient to release all of the still-building pressure, causing a Plinian eruption to commence at 7:40 p.m. Please, stay safe, everyone.